I'm Matt. I'm the CTO and co-founder of Plane.com. Our customers can support their customers on Slack, email, contact forms, headless support portals, Microsoft Teams soon, and a lot of other channels. What we realize and what we understand, I think, better than anyone else is that in B2B, and especially in technical products and startups, companies and engineers and product managers and designers have like a very, very close relationship with their customers. They talk to them every day in Slack. They involve them very early in like product design decisions and, show them beta versions of things, get feedback regularly on implementation and things. And the support there is just completely different. It's not transactional, like where's my order and bye-bye. Instead, it's much more like a relationship and it's much deeper, much more complex. And so Plane really has approached support specifically for those customers. And that has allowed us to have a very specifically good workflow for those kind of customers and teams. As any startup goes through the journey of having their customers grow, also their needs of their customers change, right? As we start onboarding bigger and bigger support teams and bigger companies overall, support became a really kind of interesting source of data. Understanding where your support is coming from essentially means you understand what your product is not doing that well. And so we started having more and more requests from our own customers to kind of better understand how their support is doing. And this is where we wanted to crack open reporting in the product itself. We wanted to allow every customer to understand deeply like where the support volume is coming from, how they're doing in different kinds of requests and for different segments of customers they might have or different tiers, and kind of really build out like a really rich reporting experience that isn't just like a reporting dashboard somewhere, but it's kind of like deeply integrated into the product. And so the use case that, we use Tinybird for in Plane is specifically to build out this kind of very rich reporting that lets you look at all of your support activity and answer questions and spot trends. When we started looking at like, okay, how you would actually go about building reporting, you quite quickly run into a lot of like scale issues, simply because you just have like a huge amount of data, even if actually quite little is going on. Every support request has a bunch of data around it. It has data such as, custom data that you might specify. It has labels, priorities, assignees, all sorts of, metadata that kind of changes over time, right? A support request comes in and then lots of things happen and eventually the support request is done. And in that arc, all of that data is somehow important to someone. And so when we started looking at like building reporting, one of the key questions was like, okay, well, how would we even do this like properly in a performant way? Like that was a really key concern we had. We at first looked into reusing what we were using for our own internal analytics, NBI, which is BigQuery. The way that our current ingestion works into BigQuery is via segment. And they have like a 6-hour or 3-hour delay, I think, on ingesting to BigQuery. So that was immediately dead in the water. If it isn't real time, it just feels immediately not trustworthy because you go to a page, you mark a thread as done, or you assign it some SLA or something, and then you go to your reports. And if that isn't immediately reflected, it just, it really breaks the trust of the reports being accurate. So we were struggling with like scale and performance really as the two core things. We're a very small team. And we really believe that we can stay a small team and be a small team because we focus on our core product. We focus on things that are really our core remit. We don't really, come to work in the morning to solve interesting technical problems. We come to work in the morning to solve interesting customer problems and build a valuable business. So that's kind of where for us, like, it quite quickly became like the driving factor for Tinybird, even though we started looking into it for performance and scale reasons. We could save ourselves all of this work and actually just focus on our product. Our backend architecture is very event-driven. We use EventBridge for eventing, I guess. At any point when anything happens in a system, an event is fired. And how our architecture works with Tinybird today is that when these events are fired, we essentially have a Lambda that picks these events up, then pipes them into Tinybird. And then we use Tinybird to kind of massage that and aggregate it and create, all these other things. And this essentially allows us to then get to a point where we have actual nice, useful API endpoints that we can use by putting it in Tinybird, right? You could just write a query. It was wrong. You just write a different one and it was immediately live and fixed. You could kind of like build a lot of these things after the fact without having to like think about the operational burden of having something live. Once we had familiarized ourselves with Tinybird, it took us about a kind of 4 weeks or a month to get to something completely working. If we hadn't used Tinybird, I think our initial version of reporting and data throughout the product, I guess in general, would have been much, much simpler and much, much more pared back and probably would have taken the same amount of time. We instead ended up with like a really complicated, really rich experience. It's kind of nice sometimes to find things like Tinybird where you kind of know that you can solve many problems with this and that it's kind of just a good, versatile, like lower level primitive. The reality is that like Tinybird is a bit like a database. You don't have to use it for reporting in product. You just can. But if you wanted to use it to like feed, you know, some sort of automated workflow or some other statistics or whatever you need, like you can. Obviously, you can do anything you want, you know, using BigQuery or just our normal database, but it's just too slow. Like it's not realistic for any real usage. So Tinybird really is the only tool we have in our stack that allows us to do anything like this.